Tyre Care 6-wheel tire pressure monitoring system monitors your tires in real time. Sensors send the tire pressure wirelessly to the solar-powered monitor in your vehicle so that you can monitor your tires while driving. This system detects abnormal tire pressures, prevents tire blowouts, and prolongs tire life. Included in the external systems box is the following: solar-powered monitor, 6 external sensors, non-slip mat, red double-sided stickers, USB power cord, wrench, spanner, 6 lock nuts, and instructional booklets. Alternatively, with the internal system, you will get the following: a solar-powered monitor, 6 internal sensors, valves, spanners, screwdriver, non-slip mat, USB power cord, red double-sided stickers, sensor inside yellow stickers, and instructional booklets. To install this system in your vehicle, start by placing the monitor on your dashboard using either the red double-sided stickers or the non-slip mat. Press and hold the minus button to turn on the monitor. Install the sensors to your wheels according to the numbers that appear on the sensors. Number 1 needs to be fitted in the front left position, while number 2 on the front right position. Number 3 will go onto the left rear position, while number 4 will go onto the right rear position of the vehicle. Number 5 and 6 will go onto the trailer or caravan. Sensor 5 is on the left side, while sensor 6 is on the right side. To fit the external sensors, start by screwing the lock nut onto the valve, and then the sensor. Be sure to secure the sensor with the lock nut. To fit the internal system, go to your nearest tire dealer to have them fit it into your tires. The screen brightness of the monitor adjusts automatically. To view the temperatures of the tires, press the plus button once. After a few seconds, the screen will automatically return to displaying the tire pressures. To change the alarm value, as well as the measuring units of the monitor, you will need to access the settings menu. This can be done by pressing the middle button on top of the monitor that is known as the set button. Press and hold this button until the screen displays bar and PSI. Now you are in the settings menu. Press the minus button. This option of the settings menu allows you to choose between a 4-wheel set and a 6-wheel set. Press the set button once. Use the plus button to choose between the two options. To save the changed setting, press the set button once. Press the plus button to return to the first option in the settings. This option in the settings menu is the pressure unit setting. Here, you can change the monitor's measuring unit between bar and PSI. To change this, press the set button once. Press the plus button once to change the measuring unit. To save the changed setting, press the set button once. Press the plus button to go to the next setting. This option of the settings menu allows you to change the temperature measuring unit between degrees Celsius and degrees Fahrenheit. To change this, press the set button once. Press the plus button once to change the measuring unit. To save the changed setting, press the set button once. Press the plus button to go to the next setting. This option of the settings menu allows you to change the high pressure alarm for the front tires. To change this setting, press the set button once. Use the plus or minus button to select the pressure for the high pressure alarm. To save the changed setting, press the set button once. The high pressure alarm will sound when the pressure exceeds the set temperature warning. Press the plus button to go to the next setting. This option of the setting menu allows you to change the low pressure alarm for the front tires. To change this setting, press the set button once. Use the plus or minus button to select the pressure for the low pressure alarm. To save the changed setting, press the set button once. The low pressure alarm will sound when the pressure goes below the set pressure warning. If a fast leak occurs, the fast leak alarm will go off. To silence the alarm, press any button. Press the plus button to go to the next setting. This option of the settings menu allows you to change the high pressure alarm for the rear tires. To change this setting, press the set button once. Use the plus or minus button to select the pressure for the high pressure alarm. To save the changed setting, press the set button once. The high pressure alarm will sound when the pressure exceeds the set pressure warning. Press the plus button to go to the next setting. This option of the setting menu allows you to change the low pressure alarm for the rear tires. To change the setting, press the set button once. Use the plus or minus button to select the pressure for the low pressure alarm. To save the changed setting, press the set button once. The low pressure alarm will sound when the pressure goes below the set pressure warning. If a fast leak occurs, the fast leak alarm will go off. Press the plus button to go to the next setting. This option of the settings menu allows you to change the high temperature setting for all the tires. Press the set button once to change the setting. Now use the plus or minus button to set the tire temperature that will sound the unit's high temperature alarm. To save the changed setting, press the set button once. Press the plus button to go to the next setting. This option of the settings menu allows you to change the wheel position for when a tire rotation is done. During wheel rotation, the positions of the internal sensors change. To adjust the position of the sensor on the monitor in accordance with that of the vehicle, press the set button once and you will see the first tire icon start flashing. Use the plus and minus button to choose which wheel you would like to change. Once you have located the tire position you would like to change, press the set button once. You will now notice the tire position numbers start to flicker. By using the plus or minus button, select the tire's new position. Press the set button once to confirm your selection. To change another tire's location, simply follow this process again. To exit the setting, press and hold the set button. It is important to note that when you return to this setting, the wheel position numbers on the screen will be the same position as you left them. This is correct. To exit the settings menu, press and hold the set button until an audible beep sound is heard. If one of the tire pressures is not displayed on the monitor, a simple drive around the block should fix this. For external sensors, after wheel rotation, simply screw the sensors on the corresponding wheels. If a sensor is damaged or lost, you can register a new sensor to the monitor. To register a new external sensor with a monitor, start by pressing the set button 5 times fast. On the screen, you will see the position of the tires displayed as two stripes. Select the position where the new sensor will be registered by using the plus button until the new sensor position is flashing. Screw the new sensor onto the valve. Wait for the monitor to make a beep sound. You will notice that the two flashing lines will now display the tire pressure. To pair another sensor, simply press the plus button until the desired position is flashing and follow the same process. To exit this menu, press and hold the set button to return to the tire pressure display. To register a new internal sensor with the monitor, first visit the nearest tire dealer and have them install the new sensor. Once the sensor is installed, start by pressing the set button 5 times fast. On the screen, you will see the position of the tires displayed as two stripes. Select the position where the new sensor will be registered by using the plus button until the new sensor position is flashing. Inflate or deflate the tire until the monitor makes a beep sound. You will notice that the two flashing lines will now display the tire pressure. To pair another sensor, simply press the plus button until the desired position is flashing and follow the same process. To exit this menu, press and hold the set button to return to the tire pressure display. Please note that when the four wheel sets are selected, you will only be able to change settings for four wheels and not for six. The monitor needs to be charged from time to time with electricity using the USB cable when the battery indicator is on one bar. If the monitor is dead, please charge with electricity using the USB cable for 3 to 4 hours. For more information on this or any of our other products, please visit our website at www.tyrecare.co.za. Get everything you need from Tyre Care.